he had a very strong movement of people who were following him because they agreed with that philosophy. He was somebody who was so passionate about life and about the cause that it kind of exuded from him. He was somebody who was very charismatic. You either loved Harvey or you couldn't stand him. Mm-hmm. There was almost no in between with him. He was irreverent about things. He made jokes about things that, you know, you shouldn't make jokes about, that because that's just who he was.
At the age of 47, on his fourth try for public office, Harvey Milk was elected to San Francisco's Board of Supervisors.
Inherit, we can't really see too much, but it looks and sounds to you and to me like New Year's Eve on Market Street, a place called Alfie's. And the reason for all this merriment and gaiety, if you pardon the pun, is the man standing to my right, the first gay supervisor elected in San Francisco. His name is Harvey Milk. First of all, congratulations, and I've never seen anything like this, Harvey.
Oh, it's all over the city tonight.
What does this mean, your election, your activity now on the Board of Supervisors in San Francisco? Does that mean, as many straights are concerned, maybe the gays are taking over San Francisco? Are you going to be a supervisor for all the people?
I have to be. That's what I was elected for. I have to be there to open up for the dialogue, for the sensitivities of all people, and for all the problems. The problems that affect this city affect all of us.
He really was a populist. He really was about the people. He cared as much about, you know, the little old lady down the street as the young gay boy from Altoona, Pennsylvania, who, you know, reached out to him and asked, like, is there any hope for me?
There are already laws on the books to protect our children. Everybody from the superintendent of schools, Wilson Riles, to Jerry Brown, to newspaper editors across the state, agree that indeed we have the laws to protect our children. I was born of heterosexual parents. I was taught by heterosexual teachers in a fiercely heterosexual society with television ads and newspaper ads, fiercely heterosexual. A society that puts down homosexuality. And why am I homosexual if I'm affected by role models? I should have been a heterosexual. And no offense meant, but if teachers are going to affect you as role models, there'd be a lot of nuns running around the streets today.
Some people say that, you know, Harvey, that the only reason that Harvey is famous now is because he was assassinated. I think, you know, I wish Harvey had lived. What an understatement. I think he would have gone on to do great things. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised at all if he'd become the mayor of San Francisco. Member of Congress, you know, who knows? He was going places. They are few and far between. Mm-hmm. And certainly, we were all his followers. We learned from Harvey. He was our teacher. Mm-hmm. And he was quite a remarkable person.
It's somewhere in Des Moines or San Antonio, there's a young gay person who all of a sudden realizes that she or he is gay, knows that if the parents find out, they'll be tossed out of the house. The classmates would taunt the child. And the Anita Bryans and John Briggs are doing their bit on TV. And that child had several options. Staying in a closet, suicide. And then one day that child might open a paper and it says, homosexual elected in San Francisco, and there are two new options. The option is to go to California. Stay in San Antonio and fight. 2 days after I was elected, I got a phone call, and the voice was quite young. It was from Altoona, Pennsylvania. And the person said, thanks. And you've got to elect gay people so that that young child and the thousands upon thousands like that child know that there's hope for a better world. There's hope for a better tomorrow. Without hope, not only gays, but those blacks and the Asians, and the disabled, the seniors, the usses, without hope, the usses give up. I know that you cannot live on hope alone, but without it, life is not worth living. And you've got to give them hope. Thank you very much.